Hello students, welcome to all of you on this channel. Our today's topic of discussion is the new chapter, which is thermodynamics third. Now, before this chapter, in thermodynamics first and second, we studied about the various thermodynamic quantities. For example, internal energy, U, heat, Q, work, W, enthalpy, H. And in thermodynamics second, we studied about the entropy denoted by S. And in this thermodynamics third chapter, we studied about two more thermodynamic quantities, which are known as work function and Gibbs free energy. So firstly, we studied about the work function. Work function is also known as Helmholtz function and Helmholtz free energy. So it is denoted by the symbol A. It is denoted by symbol A, capital A. So A is equal to U minus TS, where capital U is internal energy, capital T is temperature, and S is equal to entropy. So in this we conclude that we all know that internal energy is a state function, temperature and entropy, these are also state function. So this work function, this A, this will also be a state function. This must be a state function. In fact, it is a state function. So next kiya, hune apa study kar liya ki idhar formula. Next, to understand the physical significance of work function, to understand the exact nature of work function, we have to take any isothermal process taking place at constant temperature, that is capital T. So for initial state, we consider A1 is equal to U1 minus TS1, and for final state, this is for initial state, and for final state, A2 is equal to U2 minus T into S2. Here S2, this T remains same because we are considering an isothermal process. Isothermal process is that process in which temperature does not change during the whole process. Matlab initial te final state te oda temperature ki rahega, same rahega. So us to baad change find out karan de liye apan nu ki karna poga, subtract the equation first from equation second. A2 minus A1 is equal to U2 minus TS2 minus U1 minus TS1, and this becomes delta A. This delta A is the change in A, where A is a work function. Now right hand side to solve karenge jab apan, U2 minus U1 is equal to minus TS2 minus TS1 minus, ethe dekho re minus fir ethe plus, apan minus common le li te TS2, ethe fir minus aa jauga because minus minus ki ne ethe plus da sign hai. Ta inu solve karan to baad jehda final expression aauga, delta A is equal to delta U minus T delta S. Suppose it is equation number third. Now in this equation, delta U is the change in internal energy and delta S is equal to change in entropy, where delta U is equal to U2 minus U1 and delta S is equal to S2 minus S1. This we already discussed in previous chapter. Now according to definition of entropy, delta S is equal to Q reversible upon T. This is the definition for entropy change, and from here we conclude that T into delta S is equal to Q reversible. Suppose it is equation number fourth, if this was equation number third. Now according to first law of thermodynamics, the equation is delta U is equal to Q reversible minus work maxima. This is the equation for first law of thermodynamics when we are considering the isothermal process and reversible process. So here Q reversible and reversible process the case de vich hi work ki hunda maxima hunda. Here we are considering this minus sign because we are dealing with work of expansion. Now put the value of delta U from equation 5th and T into delta S from equation 4th into this equation number 3rd. After putting these value into equation 3rd, the final expression becomes Q reversible minus work maximum minus T delta S is jagah pe hai Q reversible. Q reversible having positive sign and this Q reversible having negative sign, these two terms cancel out with each other and here minus sign, and we can also write it as this form. This is the final expression for change in work function. So conclusion ye nikal raha ki agar apna process ho raha at a constant temperature pe, ta kiya, this represents decrease in work function because agge kiya minus the sign hai. Minus the sign agar kise change de agge lagya hoya, eda matlab initial te final value de vich jada initial te jado final value te jamange utthe decrease ho rahi hai work function di value. So conclusion is this, that a decrease in work function is equal to maximum work done by the system because we are dealing with work of expansion. So ਇਥੋਂ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਡਿਕਰੀਜ਼ ਇਨ ਵਰਕ ਫੰਕਸ਼ਨ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਇਕੁਅਲ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਮੈਕਸਿਮਮ ਵਰਕ ਡਨ ਬਾਈ ਦਿਸ ਸਿਸਟਮ. ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਥਰਮੋਡਾਇਨਮਿਕ ਕੁਆਂਟੀਟੀ ਹੈ ਇਹਦਾ ਨਾਮ ਪਿਆ ਹੋਇਆ ਵਰਕ ਫੰਕਸ਼ਨ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਇੱਥੇ ਆਪਣਾ ਵਰਕ ਦੇ ਇਕੁਅਲ ਆ ਰਿਹਾ. ਸੋ ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਹਦਾ ਨੇਮ ਪਿਆ ਹੋਇਆ ਵਰਕ ਫੰਕਸ਼ਨ. ਤੇ ਇਹਦੇ ਨੇਮ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਪਾਂ ਹੈਲਮਹੋਲਟ ਯੂਜ਼ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਹੀ ਸਾਇੰਟਿਸਟ ਨੇ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਸੀ 1882 ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ. ਜਰਮਨ ਸਾਈਕੋਲੋਜਿਸਟ ਸੀ ਜਾਂ ਫਿਜ਼ੀਸ਼ੀਅਨ ਸੀਗਾ, ਉਹਦਾ ਨਾਮ ਸੀਗਾ ਹਰਮਨ ਵੌਨ ਹੈਲਮਹੋਲਟ, ਜਿਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਹਦਾ ਅਦਰ ਨੇਮ ਹੈ ਹੈਲਮਹੋਲਟ ਫੰਕਸ਼ਨ ਐਂਡ ਹੈਲਮਹੋਲਟ ਫ੍ਰੀ ਐਨਰਜੀ. ਸੋ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਆਲ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਦੀ ਵਰਕ ਫੰਕਸ਼ਨ. ਐਂਡ ਅਵਰ ਨੈਕਸਟ ਥਰਮੋਡਾਇਨਮਿਕ ਕੁਆਂਟੀਟੀ ਇਜ਼ ਗਿਵਸ ਫੰਕਸ਼ਨ ਔਰ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਆਲਸੋ ਨੋਨ ਐਜ gives free energy. Next is gives function and it is also known as gives free energy, and both of these quantities are collectively known as free energy functions because पहला वाला की सी Helmholtz function या Helmholtz free energy, एक ये gives free energy. तो अगर आप दोनों नो combine दसना ये दोनों जोड़े Helmholtz function ते gives function होंगे ना नो collectively क्या बोलते हैं free energy functions. So gives function नो represent कितना जंदा capital G देना. So gives function is equal to H minus TS where H is equal to enthalpy or heat content and T is temperature and S is equal to entropy of the system. Now here also this enthalpy is a state function and these two are also state function. Therefore this gives free energy or this gives function, this is also a स्टेट फंक्शन. मीन्स की है ये सारे की है इन्हों की जी वैल्यू है डेल्टा की चेंज की वैल्यू वह सिर्फ डिपेंड्स करूगी स्टेट से इनिशियल से फाइनल स्टेट से वह कदम भी पाथ से डिपेंड नहीं करूगी. सो इसका फिर आप दोबारा तो फिजिकल दोबारा तो नहीं जमें आप पहला देखा हेल्महोल्ट्ज़ का वर्क फंक्शन का फिजिकल सिग्निफिकेंस. सिमिलरली अगर आप फिजिकल सिग्निफिकेंस देखना आप करना पेगा वी हैव टू consider any isothermal process at temperature capital T. initial state de bhi g1 is equal to h1 minus t into s1. Final state de bhi g2 is equal to h2 minus t s2. This is the final state. This is the expression for Gibbs free energy for final state. Means free energy at final state. This is free energy at initial state. Again, change find out karne de liye apan ki karna hoga. Subtract the equation first from equation second. After subtracting, the delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S, where delta G is equal to change in Gibbs free energy of the system. Delta G is equal to G2 minus G1. Delta H is equal to enthalpy change, which is equal to H2 minus H1. And delta S is entropy change, that is S2 minus S1. Now, physical significance dili apa jad karna, the constant temperature te entropy di value apa huni kar khede ya. At constant temperature, the entropy change is equal to Q reversible upon T. From here, T into delta S is equal to Q reversible. Suppose it is equation first, it is equation second, it is equation third, and it is equation fourth. Now, at constant pressure, according to definition of enthalpy, enthalpy change is equal to change in internal energy plus pressure into change in volume. Suppose it is equation number fifth. Put these value of delta H and T delta S into equation third. After putting these value into equation third, delta G is equal to delta H, which is equal to delta U plus P into delta V minus T delta S, which is equal to Q reversible. And we all know, according to, suppose it is equation number six. Now, according to first law of thermodynamics, delta U is equal to Q reversible minus work maximum for work of expansion. From here, delta U minus Q reversible is equal to minus of work maximum. And put this value, that is delta U minus Q reversible. Suppose it is equation number 7. Put this value from equation 7 into this equation 6. Equation cha dekho 6 de vich first part. Is equation apa kive likh sakde ha? Delta G is equal to delta U minus Q reversible plus P into delta V. Etho ta clear hai? Hun delta U minus Q reversible di value put kar do. Equation number 7 to equation number 6 de vich. Put karan to baad delta U is equal to minus of work maxima plus P into delta V. Expression ban gaya. Ta expression nu, sorry, ta delta U ni hai. Here delta G. And minus the sign agar apa left hand side te lekhe aane ha. The expression ban juga work maximum minus P into delta V having negative sign. So, itho ek conclusion nikal raha. Pahla ta A wala jada complete work hai. Inho appa net work likhna. Ida matlab decrease in Gibbs free energy is equal to net work. Net work ki ho gaya work maximum de vichon. Agar appa A wala work minus kar dange, ta inho appa ki kamange net work. So conclusion bahut vadhiya nikal raha hai is to, that decrease in Gibbs free energy when the process occurring at the constant temperature and the constant pressure, the decrease in Gibbs free energy is equal to the मैक्सिमम नेटवर्क विच इज अबटेन्ड फ्रॉम द प्रोसेस. द नेटवर्क इज दिस द मैक्सिमम वर्क माइनस दिस प्रेशर वॉल्यूम वर्क. इट इज नोन एज नेटवर्क. इस दे विच की हैगा भी इस दे विच की हरे दे जिहड़ा प्रेशर वॉल्यूम वर्क है एक ही हुंदा मैकेनिकल वर्क हुंदा. सो इस करके इस दे एक होर जिहड़ी आ इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से दैट द डिक्रीज ऑफ फ्री एनर्जी इन केस ऑफ रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस इज इक्वल टू नेट अमाउंट ऑफ नॉन मैकेनिकल वर्क इज इक्वल टू नेट अमाउंट ऑफ नॉन मैकेनिकल वर्क विच इज अबटेन्ड फ्रॉम द सिस्टम. नॉन मैकेनिकल वर्क के सारे वर्क आ जाते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इलैक्ट्रिकल वर्क हो गया, केमिकल वर्क हो गया. सो यह फिजिकल सिग्निफिकेंस इंट्रोपी का, गिब्स फंक्शन का. सो दैट्स इट.